I lived in Gloucester on the Moyer River, and as the years went by, I saw less and less crab boats. I didn't see the oysters I used to. At one occasion, I had red tide up there, a little sliver of it. The quality of the water was not the same.
So we came over to VIMS to just explore what was being done about water quality in this area, and found out about the Cytobot, and got very excited with the potential of the information that could be obtained from it.
So I particularly thought of the imaging flow Cytobot for this region because we have a whole suite of harmful algal bloom species. So generally, other regions I had studied, there was 1 to 2, maybe even 3 organisms of concern, and Chesapeake Bay tends to be about a bit of an alphabet soup, I guess. We tend to have both some of the northern and some of the southern species. So we're kind of a mix of many species, and that's what's beautiful about the imaging flow Cytobot, is that it will capture whatever's there every 20 minutes.
I was really excited when we first started getting all of the data from the Cytobot, because what I think is really interesting about it is that the images that we see are what is present in the water at that exact moment. So we're getting this high frequency, high quality data about the species of phytoplankton that are in our area at the time that we're looking at the images.
I would say the potential impact for the imaging flow Cytobot is manyfold, in that it can be for academia, for research. It can give us all this great new information about the phytoplankton and the harmful algal bloom species here. It can help benefit oyster and clam industries and letting them know what organisms might be above their grow out or potentially entering their hatcheries. One more impact of the imaging flow Cytobot in Chesapeake Bay would be the early warning system, not just to industry, but also to health officials.
The Cytobot is great, and it's giving us this high frequency data every day that we can look at, and we know exactly what our phytoplankton community is off of the VIMS pier. However, the VIMS pier is not the entire Chesapeake Bay. The future hope is to have a whole network of Cytobots that can be giving us this high frequency, high resolution data in different points. So in that way, we could get a more representative look at the entire Chesapeake Bay and the phytoplankton community structure in different parts of the bay and not just here in the York River.
It would be wonderful if, with her research, that they discover causes of different things that happen in the Chesapeake Bay. Things that will ensure that the watermen can make a living, that tourism is still thriving on the Chesapeake Bay, and that there's a water quality where no one has to worry about going swimming in the Chesapeake Bay.